this is how I'm starting a video. Totally backwards. I just wanted to show you what it looks like after about four days of driving with it. I pulled it apart because I wanted to reseal these ends. It does appear like the JB Weld that I used sucks. It worked pretty good, but where it got real hot, it didn't like it. I think I over-temped it. So I'm going to try some of this stuff. And no idea if it's going to work. But we're going to try it. We're going to coat it pretty heavy because it appears that where the JB Weld was really heavy, it seemed to be okay. But I wanted to give you a look down inside of here. If I can get the light in there. Not bad. It's hard to see, but it's wide open. You'll understand. Just keep watching the video. What's up, everybody? Just when you thought it was over, the Honda Hobbit is back. So this video is totally reversed. It's going to be really interesting to watch. I think you're going to like it because it's like, hey, this is what I did, but then you get to watch me go backwards and say, this is what I'm going to do, but you already know what I did. So it's really interesting, like, kind of gets in my head, if you want to think of it that way. So, on my, let's see, I think it was last Wednesday or something, my muffler completely just fell off. It broke in half, and you'll see that at the end of the video. And I don't know what happened, but it was a problem. And I had to ride it home with it broke off, and it was really loud. So I thought, okay, I've got a short amount of time. I've got family coming in town. I've got to try to get a muffler and make it a silencer, really is what it is, and get this thing quiet. So I thought, well, let's see what we have laying around. I'm going to build my own. So about 5 trips to the hardware store, a few other stores, and a lot of really late nights, and I accomplished my goal in about 4 days. So Thursday night, I think I started, and Friday, Saturday, Sunday night, Monday I got to drive it, and it worked. So this is a total reverse video, and I think you're going to enjoy it, because this is the end. This is my excited, thrilled, awesome, it worked face. So, yep, off to the series of start in backwards reverse time. I think you'll like it. Stick to the whole series. Yeah! I love it. I know it looks silly, but just watch the video. Now that is a total success. Only one minor problem, and I knew it may happen, and that is the high temperature sealant. It either wasn't cured fully, which I gave it plenty of time, or I just need some different stuff. I don't know. There's a little spot. You can barely even see it right there. Okay. Now I just rev that puppy up, and I can actually touch this pipe. Which, you know, it's hot right now. But when you're driving, this cools the exhaust quite nicely right in this one section. And when it gets in here, it's not quite as hot. Now, this puppy is hot. Okay? You don't want to put your hand on it for very long. So the whole thing gets very hot. But nonetheless, total success. Totally excited. And the homemade muffler cost me about $100. That's not including the aluminum cylinder. And I did have one of the valves, so yeah, you could probably get away with less than 100, Actually, it probably cost me less than that once I return a lot of the parts. I'll do a calculation and find out the exact amount, but total success, and I'm thrilled about it. I just got back, beat the rain. It's about ready to start raining out here, and I left a little early to get home, and appears that my power band is pretty strong still. I really do not have a whole lot of problems with the power band. It just seemed to work pretty well still. So, hey, I'm thrilled. Russ with RWResearch.com and a Honda Hobbit homemade silencer, because I couldn't get something quiet enough for less than like $300. And that's it. So we'll let you know all reverse.
Alright guys, I just took it for a quick little ride just to see. It's kind of just warm enough that it's kind of, you know, warm to the hand. The whole jobby.
So, I just rode it all the way up the hill to my house. Going really slow. You almost can't hear it run.
Works like a charm. Now, the question is, did it kill my power band? Because if it did, we ain't no good. So, test ride tomorrow morning on my way to work. Hopefully it doesn't fall off.
What's up? Alright, this is like the fourth night in a row, really, really late. I stayed up to get this accomplished. But there it is.
Look at that bad boy. Does that not look cool or what? So, everything fits. No touching. Oh, it's hard to see if there's a gap there. And then this guy just almost rubs it, but I can kind of move that around a little bit. I don't pedal while I'm riding. Use some straps for now. I'm probably going to try to find a different strapping system, but yeah. And then I'm probably going to put a pipe on here and face it down or something. But that's a mean machine. Now I'm going to go fire it up. Yeah. In the middle of the night, I'm going to drive it down a little ways in the park here where I'm at. Fire it up. See what happens. So, we'll see on the flip side during the day when I can let you hear it. I cranked it. It sounded quiet, so I'm kind of worried about burning my leg, so I may do something with that. But honestly, I'm kind of liking that because it's going to air cool it. So that's actually a good thing. So, it's not so hot going into here. We'll see.
Oh, that's a muffler, my friends. So here I am, out in the dark. There's the muffler. And here's the actual, like, tuned pipe part of the muffler. That's actually just the silencer. So I've, interestingly and haggardly, mounted this piece of metal, which you might be able to see back there. There you go. So it bolts down on the bottom, comes up to the top, holds this bracket on the front. Then I've got the angle bracket here mounted on this bolt, which is fine. And then I just kind of made an extension to have a double point because this thing's going to flex. It's got a lot, going to have a lot of weight on it. But as you can see, it is tight. So this guy is just going to be strapped on here about like that. Looks really funny, and it's heavy, but it's okay. It just has to quiet the noise down. And what I did here is I just welded a fitting onto the back of that, and that is going to be my way of getting that to this with this pipe. So put that together and see where we're at. Bah!
Oh, look at this! Look at this! This is beautiful, and it weighs a lot. I'll sit it down. There we go. So, this is my inlet. Boop, boop, boop. Do-do-do-do. Three times through here and back out. Now, in theory, alright, in theory, and by the way, I used the high-temperature JB Weld to make sure that the ends were sealed. I just wanted to make sure that I had... Basically, I just wanted to make sure the ends were sealed because if it leaks air, out or in, it's going to make a lot more racket. We don't like racket. I'm trying to get rid of the racket. Anyway, what was I telling you? Oh, yeah. So the idea behind this is that I could either add three silencers, or I could make a silencer with three layers in it. So that's what I did. So next is I'm going to mount this on the bike on the side somehow. And then this guy over here, this hose, it's hiding behind all the mess. It's going to be my kind of my flexible joint to the system. And then I'm going to have to weld a fitting on the muffler, which I'll show you when I get to that point. Okay, this stuff, this stinks. This is some sort of a special coating, and it smells awful, and it gets all over your hands. So, anyway, see you in the next bit. By the way, it's really late again, but I'm feeling good. But I'm going to quit. I got to get up early tomorrow, do some stuff. Oh, well, I lied. I'll show you what it looks like. So I packed three of those sponges in one side. I was able to get three of them in there. And it is packed tight. So, you're looking good. Still open. So, we should be good. Bada boom, bada bing, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, my goodness gracious. Been on here for too many hours. I actually went to the store and got another fitting. So, what in the world's going on here? So, this is basically what is going to be inside, okay, of this. So, each one of these three channels is going to have its own separated space where it can isolate some sound, I hope. So I'm going to wrap these things, pack them tightly and nicely with the steel wool, stainless steel wool. But I just wanted to give you a visual of what this thing actually looks like. This is what it's going to look like inside this thing. And that's it. Next thing you're going to see is this thing full of crap. It's going to be just bolted together. That's the next thing you're going to see. I did also get these rings inside of here. That was quite fun. They're in there, though. They ain't coming out. So, that's it. Next phase. Pack it. Stick it. Do it. Oh, man. It's another late night. So, I'm out here. You can tell I've been digging through my parts. Got kind of like boxes and bins of parts and fittings and stuff. And this is what I come up with. So from the muffler to the new silencer, I'm going to be using this tube because I can flex it. And one of the problems with this tube is I needed a bushing because it had originally in a rubber fitting. This is a stainless steel tube. So I decided to make some. So I had some of this old... really small. This is actually, see if I can find the end of it. This is actually tubing. See, it's got a hole in it. This focus doesn't work either. So it's got a hole in it. It's tubing. So I decided I was going to make my own bushing. So this is what I came up with. And these are just kind of like crush washers for the exhaust. It's basically exactly what it is. Except I'm going to be putting these inside of the ends of this tube. And when I tighten down a fitting like this, it will make a seal on the edge. Okay, so there's kind of a test piece here. Fits quite on there, quite nice. And yep, I'm just going to keep moving on. I got another section to make here. And and then what I was going to do for the ends, I got some ball valves. So you can unscrew these ball valves right here. And then take the guts out of it and the handle off. And I'm going to drill a hole in here and use that, okay, as my, of course, take all the parts out. But I'm going to be using this as, and I'm going to drill it out, as my clamp to hold this piece into this stainless steel because I was trying to figure out how I was going to make that work. So I'm going to make it work. I hope. More later. Oh... Oh, it's too late. So I've been out here bending metal, Trying to use every piece of scrap iron and clamp I've got to make me some jigs so I can, like, nicely bend this sheet aluminum. So I had this sheet aluminum. It's an old sign. And I wanted to make dividers. And I was going to originally use three of these, but I ended up just using these two. So I've created dividers inside here. And they are, like, beat in there. They're tight as tight can get. They're not going to vibrate. They should be good. Need to maybe make some adjustments there on that. But, yeah, so I riveted them together on one side. And three rivets, as you can see there. And then this piece is going to go in here, right? And then this piece is going to go in here, like this. All right, so when you look down in here, you've got... this will be like, this one will be like the inlet or exit. It will go down there and go through the pipe, come back up through this pipe, back down through that pipe, and then that empty one will be the exit. So these fit perfectly. I had to bend it around there, so I had to spot my all thread to go through. That was a pain in my butt. I got it. And so that should work out quite nicely. All right, I'm done. It's late. I'm tired, and I'm gonna have to figure out exactly how to get all this in here and make it work. Oh dear. All right, more later. What's up, gentle people? My name's Russ. Okay, it's a new day. I like coffee. Oh man, this is how I used to feel. I've been up for way too many hours, and I'm like, wow. Anyway, so I'm drinking coffee. So I went to the hardware store and I bought some stuff. There's my cylinder. I decided I was going to use this cylinder. I think it's going to work okay. I found some end caps. I haven't test fit these yet. Oh, look at that. Look at that. How nice is that? These are clean out covers for wall clean outs. I don't know. 4 inches. So these fit on this contour that's right inside this drum. And I'm actually going to be taking this piece of all thread when I'm completely done with this muffler and running it all the way through. And that's how it's going to stay together, these two end caps. So these should work out, but you know, I don't know. Maybe I could do something different. I don't know, dude. I went to there and I bought a bunch of stuff and I'm like, it's going to have to work. So... next, I got some plumbing parts. These are Street 90s, where they fit inside of each other. And then I'm going to cut this out and grind it down so I can make these pretty much street turns. And then that's going to be my turn for the end here. That's roughly the same diameter as my wire form. I'll figure out how I'm going to make that work. Then I bought some other... two plumbing fittings, which I might bring back because I think I might have what I need already here if I just got to dig it out. But, yeah, so I'm going to actually weld a 3/4 inch piece of pipe. I think I'm going to use 3/4 that'll slide over the original muffler part and weld it onto there. And then I'm going to actually make this muffler threadable. I'm going to thread it on there. So I'm actually going to put a fitting like this on this plate, okay, and then I'll be able to actually thread the muffler onto the other muffler. That's the plan, Stan. I'll see what. Oh, and I bought steel wool. So okay, I bought steel wool. Remember my last experience, and I packed the mufflers with actual steel wool, and this is kind of what it looks like. And I didn't really think about this, but steel wool is flammable. You can light this with a lighter and it will explode in big, nice, beautiful arcs and sharks and everything. So, I got stainless steel. Now, these were about $3. $2.50, maybe $2.50 for a package. I think I could probably stuff about 3 packs in here if I do it right. I want them pretty dense. So, I bought plenty of extra and I'll bring the other ones back. So, that's the plan. Stan. All right, we'll see. Oh my gosh, let's see how this works out. It's getting a little interesting, huh? Hey, if I wasn't doing it, y'all think I'd be crazy. Someone else doing it would be crazy. But hey, it's just me. It's normal. All right, peace. See you when it's
later time.
Yep. All right, so if and when this ever decides to focus. So I took this stuff and turned it into this. And this is a really nice perforated tube. So as you can see, you can pretty much see right through it, right where the lights are at. Okay. But it's actually a pathway down through there. Now I used copper wire to tie these things up because I didn't want them rusting if I used like baling wire or steel wire or something. And this stuff stays together pretty good by itself, but the copper will hold it in place in case it wants to try to unravel. And what I did is I just rolled it on this PEX pipe. I rolled that whole entire piece, the length of that, one little kind of a little piece at a time, and worked it left to right, until I got it wrapped. So I'll be cutting this in length, but I just decided to roll it all at once. Why not? We'll see if it can be done that way, and yes, it can. Now I'm going to buy some elbows to make some 90-degree bends, because I thought maybe I could roll this stuff and make like a 90-degree bend or something like that, and then wrap some more around it. But I think the best thing to do to make sure that the pathway is nice and clean is just to make a 90 with some copper pipes. I'm going to take two copper 90s and just make a 90. I know it's not the best flow through. It's not real smooth, but if I can find something different at the hardware that I can bend that tight, then I'll do it. See where we come up next. It's like Back to the Future, man, except Honda Hobbit style. I just need some, like, you know, rope lights that glow blue in colors, and then a little bit of flames, and you know, I've got the right Cali license plate. It just needs to say out of time. Oh, jeez. It's funny. All right, so this roller was designed to get into the heat, but it's quite interesting right now because it's crackled. Check it out. Look at that. Isn't that interesting? And watch this. It just falls off. So now I'm going to have this beautiful cylinder. Beautiful aluminum cylinder. It'll look pretty nice on there. I'll show you a picture when it's done. And this is what my workshop looks like when I'm working on a project. Most of the time with limited time. But you know, it is what it is. And it is a big giant mess. Wow. Yowzers. Well, I'm back. It's been about, I don't know, a month, I think, and I was going to end that video right all in reverse, but decided to add this on the end because, well, I decided to go a little bit further, and I haven't posted that video yet, so tells you how many videos I probably have. It's ridiculous. So much content, but anyway. So, here's what I did. This is the original plates. Now, one of the things that's important about this is that you can build this with all stuff you can find around around town, right? This tubing actually could have been a piece of exhaust pipe from your local parts store, automotive parts store. They had pipe roughly this size, so I would say that you could actually build this entire apparatus with stuff laying around in your hardware stores. Just got to look around. So these plates worked actually really good, except they're too flexible, and or the weight that I had on the end of this guy, right, was a lot of weight, and also the piping connected to the bike motor wanted to vibrate a little bit. So I did use, let stuff go, I did use some of this exhaust system crack and joint sealer. I did use some of this after I did the JB Weld.
I took the JB Weld. I took it apart. The JB Weld would have worked really, really well if I would have sanded these smooth stainless steel plates. That was partly my problem. I didn't realize I should have sanded these. Because the JB Weld in here is stuck very nicely. You can see around the outside there. It's really hard. You can't really break it loose. That stuff stuck really well. But because this vibrated, it broke loose. I bet if I'd have sanded it, it'd have been all right. Now, then I used this joint crack sealer stuff. This is junk, except it does turn really, really, really like rock hard if you do it right. As far as actually filling in a crack, not so much. So, I don't know. It's not very good stuff, to be honest. But hey, it is what it is. So here's what I did. I had some aluminum wheels. These were for an encoder. They used to have a hub right here, but I milled it off nicely. And it's funny, both of these are almost identically milled off, like the high and the low points. But anyway, so here's what I did. I milled that off so I had a flat piece of aluminum. Then I just cut the inside edge here so that you can fit this guy right on the edge. Boom! What this is going to do, it's going to give me more rigid connection here. So actually the pipe and the piece are what's holding this guy together, and the rod that's going to go through the center is only holding the plates from falling off the end. So that's going to get rid of my problem that I was having with the vibration thing going on. So I just wanted to give you an update. I'll show you what it looks like on the bike when I'm done, but I went ahead and went for machining. I didn't want to do machining on these guys. I wanted to do it without, but unfortunately it was leaking between here and this plate. And, well, it got really loud real quick when I did that. So I'll give you an update afterwards. Okay. Bye. Hey again, really quickly, I wanted to show you how I made these connections this time. You can see about how thick that aluminum is. What, eighth? That's about a quarter inch thick. And I threaded these so I could thread this pipe all the way through. Okay, put it in the right place. Like that. Then take my other fitting, or coupling, or whatever I wanted to use here, and actually still had enough thread sticking out this way to thread it on all the way and make it tight. So make an actual pipe thread seal there. So, just wanted to show you real quickly. Once these things are bolted together and this guy's all clipped together, and then you got all your torque here, you know, I'm going to JB weld this. I think it will stand this time since I've sanded it. So anyway, just wanted to show you what kind of connection I was just making there, because I think it's good to know. I'm going to JB weld the backside too, just to make it all nice and sealed. Ta-da! Okay, so it's another late night. It's about 10 o'clock. I don't know. So here it is. Man, this is a beautiful looking thing now. Should probably paint those black, kind of ugly. So if you can see how the JB Weld nicely is in that little groove and all the way on the inside. Same thing on this side. Kind of self-levels into that little cubby. And I did just the washers on this side and this side. Just the washers, not the nuts. There's the outlet pipe. Just barely sticks out. Looks good. Unlike before it was a valve. And on this side I just put a coupling back to my bigger size that fixed my my pipe. So yeah, it looks pretty good. That's a nice looking machine. And here's a little sound for you. Ridiculous, right? I know. I did pressure test this with just the pressure I could get out of my lungs, and it held pressure for, you know, I don't know, I tested it for like 30 seconds. So, it actually poof when I let go of the other side. So, sweet. And it is very strong. I kind of bent around on this guy to see if this would move at all, and no, it ain't going anywhere. Much better. Bada boom, bada bing, baby. That's it.
I ran it today. Runs good. No loose connections here. Yes. What? Crazy kids. Now all I gotta do is replace the tire. Check it out. I got no treads left. Look at that. Completely bald right there. Here's what a good one looks like. So that's the next step. I also put that cover on. Alright, peace out. Say bye, kids.
Bye.
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 Bye.